the next topic, conventional current. Conventional current means in the electrical circuit, the arrow heads indicate the direction of the electric current. So according to this diagram, the current is to flow from the positive terminal to negative terminal of the battery. So the arrow head is used to indicate the direction of flow of current. Students, like this, the current is to flow from the positive terminal to negative terminal, in which the positive charges are moving from the positive terminal to negative terminal of the battery. This current is called conventional current or simply current. The current is called conventional current or simply current. In a typical circuit, the flow of the charges that are actually electron flows from the negative terminal to positive terminal of the battery. As a result, the flow of electron is called current, that is a typical current. Like the directions of the typical current is opposite to the directions of the conventional current. Okay, in a typical circuit, actually the electrons are transferring from the negative terminal to positive terminal. So that flow of the charges is called current. So the current direction is mentioned like the directions of the flow of the electron from negative terminal to positive terminal. So the directions of the conventional current is opposite to the direction of the typical current. Okay, according to the directions of the typical current is opposite to the directions of the conventional current. Okay students, mathematically the number of charges, that is number of positive charges transferring, is same as to the number of negative charges transferring in the opposite direction. Okay students, right? So like the electric current is not only produced by battery, it is not only produced by the battery. During lightning bolt produces enormous electric current in a short time. During lightning, there is produced an enormous electric current in short time. So very high potential difference is created between the clouds and the ground. So the charges flow between the clouds and the ground. Okay students, follow that. We are going to discuss drift velocity. To explain drift velocity, we consider one conductor. In a conductor, it has a charge carrier, that is a free electron, and it is also having positive charges. Okay students, so in a conductor, the charge carriers are electrons. These electrons moves freely through the conductor and collide with the positive ions If there is no electric field at initial position, there is no electric field, these electrons moves in random direction. So the directions of their velocity are also completely random. Okay students, here an average, the number of electrons traveling in any direction will be equal to the number of positive charges traveling in the opposite direction. So as a result, there is no net flow of electron in any direction, and hence there will be not be any current. Okay, if there is no electric field is applied, there is no current flow through the conductor. Suppose a potential difference is applied to the conductor, that is when the battery is connected to the conductor, the electric field is applied to the conductor. So this electric field exerts a force on the electron, produce a current. The electric field accelerates the electron, while ions scatter the electron and change the directions of the motion of the electron. Thus, we have zigzag path of the electron. Okay, when the electric field is applied, here this electron, it has a zigzag path.
So we have the zigzag paths of electron in addition to the zigzag motion of the electron due to the collision.
Okay, friends, you need to understand, we have zigzag paths of the electron in addition to the zigzag motion due to the collision. The electrons move slowly along the conductor in the direction opposite to the electric field. The direction opposite to the electric field, the electrons moves along the conductor. So the velocity is called drift velocity. Okay, the electrons moves opposite to the directions of the electric field, no? So at the time it has a velocity is called drift velocity, is not a vector, Vd vector. The drift velocity is the average velocity accrued by the electron. What is the meaning for drift velocity? It is the velocity accrued by the electron. It is the velocity accrued by the electron inside the conductor. Inside the conductor when it is subjected, to an electric field. This means when the electric field is applied, the electrons moves opposite to the directions of the applied electric field. So the velocity accrued by the electron is called drift velocity. Okay friends, is it clear? Right. So the average time taken between the successive collision is called mean free time. It is denoted by letter tau. Okay, so what is the meaning for mean free time? The average time between the successive collision. The average time between the successive collision is called the mean free time, denoted by the letter tau. So the acceleration of the electron is noted by letter A vector. The acceleration of the electron is noted by letter A vector. So we can calculate the acceleration experienced by the electron in an electric field E is A vector. A vector is equal to that force experienced by the electron minus E vector divided by M. This is from the according to the Newton's second law, we know that the force F is equal to M into A. What is the acceleration? A is equal to F divided by M. Here the force experienced by the electron, that is minus E into A. When the electric field is applied, the electron exert a force. Okay, due to the electric field, there is experience of force. So the force experienced by the electron by the electric field, the force experienced by the electron when the electric field is applied, that is minus E vector divided by the mass of the electron is M, small letter M. Okay students, so the acceleration A vector is equal to minus E divided by M. So from the acceleration we are going to calculate the drift velocity. So the average the drift velocity Vd vector is calculated by using the formula of, what is the meaning for drift velocity? Vd vector is equal to acceleration into mean time. Because what is in the acceleration? Acceleration is rate of change of velocity. So that is Vd divided by the time tau. From this we need the values of the Vd. So Vd vector is equal to A vector into tau. So you know the values of the A vector. It is substituted in this equation, means we can substitute Vd vector is equal to minus E vector divided by M into
tau. From this we can write the values of the E tau divided by m is noted by mu into E vector. Okay, so the Vd is equal to minus mu into E vector. So what is the meaning for mu? Mu is equal to, the mu is equal to E tau divided by m. This is called mobility of the electron.
It is called mobility of the electron. So what is in the mobility? It is defined as the magnitude of the trip to velocity, magnitude of the trip to velocity per unit electric field, magnitude of the trip to velocity per unit electric field. Okay, so from the formula we can substitute we know that the Vd vector is equal to minus mu E vector. So what is the meaning for mu? That mu is equal to modulus of Vd vector divided by E vector. Okay students, so that is, it is defined as the magnitude of the trip to velocity per unit electric field. The SI unit of the mobility, the SI unit of mobility is meter square per volt second. Meter square per volt second. Thank you students.